A policy think tank urges the public to keep a close eye on how the unprogrammed funds in the 2024 national budget will be used. The unprogrammed funds in next year's budget reached 731 billion pesos after a 450 billion peso hike was approved by lawmakers. The Institute for Leadership, Empowerment and Democracy cites several reasons why this should be a cause for concern.
This may be used for patronage politics. The other concern about the unprogrammed appropriations is a new provision that was introduced by Congress as to how the unprogrammed appropriations will be tapped. In the past, there are only three sources: new revenues, excess revenue collections, or foreign loans. But Congress introduced a new provision now which says the government, particularly the executive branch, can tap into the reserve funds of GOCCs, and particularly GOCCs that are unable to disburse funds that were provided by the national government. Now, why is this concerning? It's precisely because this is very similar to the initial version of the Maharlika Investment Fund.
The Philippine government's 2024 budget, signed into law by President Ferdinand Marcos Jr., the bulk of the spending plan is allocated to education and infrastructure. Katrina Domingo tells us more.
The Philippine government will see a 500 billion peso increase in its national budget in 2024. That's after President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. signed the 5.76 trillion peso spending measure, which is 9.6% higher than this year's national budget. The chief executive says the minimal increase is deliberate, as his administration is trying to reduce the government's borrowings.
Like any government, we are curtailed by what we can collect, by what our tax coffers contain. We can be reckless, take the easy path, borrow, let our children pick today's tab up tomorrow. But debt is not the kind of inheritance that we want to leave those who will come after us.
Budget Secretary Amina Pangandaman says the Philippines' debt under the 2024 General Appropriations Act shrunk to 5% from this year's 6.1%. The Marcos Jr. administration hopes to further pull down this number to 3% before the president steps down in 2028. While the palace has yet to release a full copy of the 2024 GAA, the budget secretary says among the sectors that will receive big chunks of the budget include the education, infrastructure, and social amelioration sectors. She adds the president did not directly veto line items under the 2024 budget.
Walang direct veto, most of it are conditional and general observations. Ang general observations po, parang may mga comments lang on how to implement the budget. Ang conditional implementation, subject to implementing rules and regulations or guidelines to be issued by respective departments. So yun, kini-clear lang po namin yun.
But former Senator Franklin Drilon says he agrees with Minority Leader Coco Pimentel's recommendation for the president to veto the unprogrammed funds.
Kaya ako sangayon na dapat i-veto yan. Hindi po sa dahilan na labag sa saligang batas, kung hindi sa dahilan na ginamit itong paraan na ito para lakihan ang pork barrel. Ulitin ko lang para huwag maliwanag sa ating mga kababayan. Ang unprogrammed funds ay pwede at ang program projects ay pwede mo lang gamitin kung ang revenues, ang taxes natin na nakukolekta
ay lampas,
ay mahigit doon sa program ng pamahalaan. Halimbawa lang, kung ang program na revenue na taxes ay 1 billion, pag lumagpas ng 1 billion, sabihin natin ng 1.1 billion, ang 0.1 billion pwede mong gamitin sa ang program funds or program project.
Senate President Juan Miguel Zubiri says the budget of the defense sector was hiked by 10 billion pesos as the Philippines plans to procure three large ships for the Philippine Coast Guard next year. Meantime, the president reminds government officials to spend the 2024 fund judiciously to ensure that the public will enjoy the full rebate of their taxes.
Implementation delay and illegal deviations inflict the same havoc of denying the people of the progress and development that they deserve. So with this reminder comes the most important budget commandment that we must always heed. We are working for the people. not for ourselves. We are working for the country, not for ourselves.
So far, the government has yet to fully consume its 5.2 trillion budget for 2023. Pangandaman says while the government has released 98% of the fund, only 80% has been utilized. But the budget chief adds that this should not be a problem as the 2023 budget has a two-year validity and will expire in 2024. Katrina Domingo, ABS-CBN News.
Act with caution. That dire warning coming from China's top diplomat as it confronts the Philippines over their tense encounters at sea. Wang Yi held a phone call with his Philippine counterpart, Secretary Enrique Manalo, Wednesday. And during that call, Wang said the two countries are at a crossroads with the future of their ties uncertain. He also rehashed statements from Beijing's foreign ministry on how Manila is the one steering trouble. As for the Philippines, Manalo says both sides underscored the importance of dialogue and addressing issues. The call follows stark remarks from President Ferdinand Marcos Jr., who said ties between Manila and Beijing are headed in a poor direction. He also called for a paradigm shift in dealing with China's aggression. The board of the Maharlika Investment Corporation takes shape as President Marcos swears in four new directors: Vicky Castillo Tan, Andrew Jerome Gan, Herman Lechauco, and Roman Felipe Reyes took their oaths Wednesday. Tan, a longtime ADB executive, worked at various financial institutions, including Citibank, while Gan held various director roles with the likes of Globeland Development Corporation. Meanwhile, Lechauco has served as a director for Sharp Philippines, and Reyes is currently a director at Converge ICT Solutions. Four slots of the board that will manage the country's first sovereign wealth fund are already filled by ex-officio members. These are MIC President Rafael Consing Jr., Finance Chief Benjamin Diokno, Budget Chief Amena Pangandaman, and NEDA Secretary Arsenio Balisacan. The Philippine Central Bank ruling out rate cuts for now as inflation remains elevated. The BSP, though, remains bullish. The Consumer Price Index will finally fall back to the target range, even just at the high end, by 2024, Lady Vicentro reports.
Interest rates in the Philippines are expected to stay elevated as inflation remains above government's target range. Banco Central ng Pilipinas Governor Eli Remolona said even though inflation is expected to ease within the 2-4% target range in 2024, the Monetary Board is on the lookout for other factors such as GDP and inflation expectations before considering to loosen monetary policy.
If most of the numbers point in the right direction, including expectations, they really settle into this comfortable range around 3% for inflation, then we will consider cutting rates.
Philippine headline inflation slowed to 4.1% in November. The central bank projects inflation to further ease below 3% in the first quarter of 2024, even factoring in a strong El Nino that may affect supply in the first quarter. Weakening demand for commodities is taming inflation expectations for next year.
But the overall outlook also, so apart from oil prices, we look at non-oil prices. Demand is weakening in the major economies. That's also providing a downward influence on commodity prices.
Moderate impacts of El Nino in the second quarter of 2024 are projected to push inflation above 3%. But Remolona is confident inflation is expected to settle near the ceiling of the target for 2024. Lady Vicentio, ABS-CBN News.
The State Weather Bureau warns Western Luzon will be the first to bear the brunt of the El Nino phenomenon, and months ahead of its expected peak, two provinces are already experiencing drought. Rafael Bosano with this report.
The Philippines is beginning to feel the effects of El Nino, with the provinces of Nueva Ecija and Central Luzon and Cavite and Southern Luzon already experiencing drought, according to the State Weather Bureau. At least 25 areas in different parts of the country are also dealing with a dry spell, while five others are grappling with dry conditions. An area is considered to be experiencing dry condition if it receives below normal rainfall for two consecutive months. A dry spell, on the other hand, is described as below or way below normal rainfall conditions for a longer period. The worst condition is drought, characterized by 5 consecutive months of below normal or 3 months of way below normal rainfall. Pagasa warns the number of areas affected by the El Nino through dry conditions, dry spells, and droughts will likely increase, the most of which is forecast in April.
Majority of global climate models suggest that El Nino will likely persist until March-April, May 2024. While stronger El Nino events increases the likelihood of El Nino-related climate anomalies, it does not necessarily equate to strong impacts or emerge in all locations.
This means that while rainfall may be below normal in most parts of the country, some areas, particularly Mindanao, will still get showers. Below normal rainfall will first be felt by the western section of Luzon in the first month of 2024. This will stretch to almost all of Luzon and a big portion of Visayas by February. Normal rains are forecast to return to majority of the Philippines by May and June, the period of transition to La Niña. The greatest impact of El Niño is on the water supply, which is needed for agriculture and everyday living. The public is also encouraged to conserve water and immediately repair or report leaking water lines. Rafael Bosano, ABS-CBN News.